singing Alleluia.
We begin our celebration in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the Lamb of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear sisters and brothers, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Together we say, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, graciously keep from us all adversities, so that unhindered in mind and body alike, we may pursue in freedom of heart the things that are yours. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the third letter of Saint John. Beloved, you are faithful in all you do for the brothers and sisters, especially for strangers. They have testified to your love before the church. Please help them in a way worthy of God to continue their journey, for they have set out for the sake of the name, and you are accepting nothing from the pagans. Therefore, we ought to support such persons so that we may be co-workers in the truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed the man who fears the Lord.
Blessed the man who fears the Lord.
Blessed the man who fears the Lord, who greatly delights in his commands. His posterity shall be mighty upon the earth. The upright generation shall be blessed.
Blessed the man who fears the Lord.
Wealth and riches shall be in his house. His generosity shall endure forever. Light shines through the darkness for the upright. He is gracious and merciful and just.
Blessed the man who fears the Lord.
Well for the man who is gracious and lends, who conducts his affairs with justice. He shall never be moved. The just one shall be in everlasting remembrance.
Blessed the man who fears the Lord. Please stand.
Alleluia. Our Lord Jesus Christ. Alleluia. 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 Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus told these disciples a parable about the necessity for them to pray always without becoming weary. He said, "There was a judge in a certain town who neither feared God nor respected any human being. And a widow in the town used to come to him and say, 'Render a just decision for me against my adversary.' For a long time, the judge was unwilling, but eventually he thought, 'While it is true that I neither fear God nor respect any human being, because this widow keeps bothering me, I shall deliver a just decision for her, lest she finally come and strike me.' The Lord said, 'Pay attention to what the dishonest judge says. Will not God then secure the rights of his chosen ones who call out to him day and night? Will he be slow to answer them? I will tell you, he will see to it that justice is done from them speedily. But when the Son of Man comes, will he find faith on earth?'" Sisters and brothers, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to this day's Pilgrim's Mass, as we offer all our intentions under the grace and love of Jesus the Nazarene. Our Gospel is a reflection of perseverance. Of all the people mentioned, why widow is specified? Pwede namang ibang tao, pero bakit iyong balo? Hindi ba kayo nag-iisip? Hindi nyo ba nakikita? Pwede namang isang magsasaka, katulad ng ginagamit ni Jesus sa iba niyang mga parables. Pero this time, Jesus used the widow. Dahil po, ang widow o ang taong wala ng asawa noong unang panahon, ang taong balo ang siyang pinakakawawa sa lipunan. Bakit po? Dahil ang kayamanang maiiwanan ng kaniyang asawa ay pwedeng kunin ng kaniyang mga kapatid. So wala ng parang legal personality ang isang widow. Siya ay nawawala ng karapatan sa lahat ng bagay. Kahit na ang pag-aasawang muli ay hindi niya pwedeng gawin, dahil ang pwede lamang kumuha sa kaniya at maging asawang muli ay kapatid na lalaki ng namatay. Ibig sabihin, wala talagang karapatan ang isang widow sa panahon ni Moses. Ginamit ni Jesus ang talinhagang ito upang ipakita na ang taong wala ng kakayahan sa buhay, ang Diyos na lamang ang kaniyang magiging kayamanan. Ang judge na ipinapakita ay ang Diyos na nakikinig sa isang persistent widow sa pamamagitan ng kaniyang panalangin. That's why Jesus used this parable to teach one reality, na tayong lahat ay hindi dapat mapapagod sa pananalangin. Because prayer is fueled by faith, and faith is increased by prayer. Prayer and faith are two sides of the same coin. No one who has faith will not be able to pray what is right. And one who does not know how to pray will not be able to understand the kind of faith that one possesses. That's why Jesus is clear in giving advice to his disciples to pray without ceasing, to pray without becoming weary. Hindi tayo dapat mapagod sa pananalangin kahit alam na ng Diyos ang laman ng panalangin iyan, dahil ang tinitingnan niya ay ang pagtsatsaga ng taong nananalangin para sa kanya. In fact, prayer is not for God. Prayer is for us who need God. Katulad ng widow o babaeng ito na talagang pinipilit niya na siya'y bigyan ng hustisya dahil wala na siyang hustisyang matatamu pa sa mga taong napasapaligid niya, kaya siya'y pumunta sa isang hukom, at ang hukom na iyon ay walang iba kung hindi ang Diyos na nakakaalam kung ano ang tama at kung ano ang mabuti sa isang taong wala nang kalakasang sumunod at humingi sa kanya. It is with great fervor that we see the widow in her persevering attitude to ask and seek the justice in God. Therefore, mercy is not mercy without justice. Only God listens to a prayer when it is founded on mercy and founded on justice. Hindi ka pwedeng manghingi sa Diyos ng para lamang sa'yo. Kailangang ito ay nakabase sa hustisya at awa ng Diyos. Minsan hindi natin mauunawaan. Minsan hindi natin mapagtsatsagaang hintayin ang sagot ng Diyos. Pero mind you, God is listening. Only He is testing our faith on how founded we are on the words of Him and on the gospel of mercy and justice. Let us not lose our control in connecting with God. Only through prayer that we connect entirely to the mercy and justice of God. Let us not be weary on our personal and communal prayer. As long as we connect to God, our prayers will be answered. May the Lord bless us all today.
Please all stand.
We must pray unceasingly and never lose heart. Our God will see justice done to His chosen ones, who cry out to Him day and night. Encouraged by this teaching of our Lord, let us come to the Father with our intercessions. Father, listen to our prayers.
Father, listen to our prayers.
That the Church, through its ministers, may persevere amidst all her trials and tribulations and never lose confidence in proclaiming the gospel. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father, listen to our prayers.
That those who are discouraged and are tempted to give up the struggle in leading a good life may find new inspiration in the faithfulness of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father, listen to our prayers.
That those who find praying difficult may grow in fervor and make room for God in their daily lives. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father, listen to our prayers.
That the sick may persevere in their sufferings and never lose heart. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father, listen to our prayers.
That the dead may receive the heavenly reward for their perseverance on earth. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father, listen to our prayers.
In the silence of our hearts, let us pray for our personal and family intentions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Father, listen to our prayers.
Heavenly Father, we entrust our needs to you. Show us the way to pray unceasingly so that we may always be united to you. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Lord, here I am to answer your call. Lord, here I am.
Brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
Look with favor, we pray, O Lord, upon the sacrificial gifts offered here, that celebrating in mystery the passion of your Son, we may honor it with loving devotion. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In Him you have been pleased to renew all things, giving us all a share in His fullness. For though He was form of God, He emptied Himself and by the blood of His cross brought peace to all creation. Therefore He has been exalted above all things, and to all who obey Him has become the source of eternal salvation. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis our Pope and Jose our Bishop and all the clergy, remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by the divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with the will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
This is Jesus, the just judge, who listens to our prayers. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Para sa lahat ng tatanggap ng banal na komunyon, sasagot po tayo ng Amen pagkasabi ng pari o ng lay minister ng katawan ni Kristo at isubo agad sa bibig bago umalis sa harapan ng pari o lay minister. Sumunod po tayo.
Sa Diyos lang mapapanalangin ang aking kaluluwa sa Kanya nagmumula ang aking pag-asa at kaligtasan. Sa Diyos lamang mapapanatag ang aking kaluluwa. Sa Kanya nagmumula pag-asa at kaligtasan. O Diyos, Ikaw ang aking kaligtasan, nasa iyo aking kaluwalhatian. Ikaw lamang aking inaasahan at tanggulan. Sa Diyos lamang mapapanatag ang aking kaluluwa. Sa Kanya nagmumula ang aking pag at kaligtasan. Paniniling di ko pa nanaligan, puso'y di iigit sa yaman, kundi sa Diyos na makapangyarihan na aking lakas at takbuhan. Sa Diyos lamang mapapanatag ang aking kaluluwa. Sa Kanya nagmumula ang aking pag-asa at kaligtasan. Oo, ika'y puno ng kabutihan, pastol kang nagmamahal sa kawal. Inaakay sa lunti ang pastulan, upay hanap mo ako kung mapaglitma. Sa Diyos lamang mapapanata ang aking kaluluwa. Sa Kanya nagmumula ang aking pag-asa at kaligtasan. Sa Diyos lamang mapapanatag ang aking kaluluwa. Sa Kanya nagmumula ang aking pag-asa at kaligtasan.
Announcement. Inihahandog po ng programang Home Base Plus ang mga kwento ng himala ng poong Jesus Nazareno. Ito po ay mga dokumentaryo sa mga buhay na binago ng ating Nuestro Padre Jesus Nazareno. Mapapanood po ito bukas Linggo sa ganap na ika-anim ng umaga sa GMA 7. Gayun din, para sa mga nais magbahagi ng kanilang mga kwento ng Himala ng Nazareno, mangyari na mag-email sa himalanangnazareno@gmail.com. Inaanyayahan po ang lahat na sumubaybay. Available pa rin po ang ating mga All Souls envelope sa mga nagnanais. Maaari kayong kumuha na malapit sa mga pintuan ng ating simbahan o sa information guard. Isulat lamang po ang mga pangalan ng mga kamag-anak, kaibigan at mga kakilalang na mayapa o sumakabilang buhay na. At sa buong buwan ng Nobyembre, ito po ay ating isasama sa lahat ng mga misa na nagaganap sa ating simbahan. Pagkatapos ng misa, wiwisikan po ang lahat ng banal na tubig. Pinakikiusapan ng lahat na manatili lamang muna sa inyong mga lugar. Tanging sa Quezon Boulevard o sa Plaza San Juan lamang ang labasan ng lahat. Sumunod po tayo. Maraming salamat po sa inyong pagdalaw at pagsisimba sa Basilica Minor at Pambansang Dambana ni Jesus Nazareno. Please stand.
Let us pray. Nourished by this sacred gift, O Lord, we give you thanks and beseech your mercy, that by the pouring forth of your Spirit, the grace of integrity may endure in those you heavenly powered has entered, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Now we will pray for our faithful departed. Let us pray. O God, the Creator and Redeemer of all faithful, grant unto the soul of your servants and handmaids the remission of all their sins, that through these devout supplications they may obtain the pardon which they have always desired. Absolve, O Lord, we beseech you, the soul of your servants and handmaids from every bond of sin, that in the glory of the resurrection they may be raised up with your saints and elect unto newness of life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord.
And let perpetual light shine upon them.
May the soul of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your head and ask for God's blessing for pilgrims' blessing. Blessed are you, O God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. You have given us your only Son to be our way to you. Make us follow him generously, faithfully, and lovingly. Merciful Jesus of Nazareth, you have revealed God's grace and unconditional love for us at the cross. You set your church in this world from which the true light would shine for all to see. Grant that we who enter this holy shrine may walk in your ways as disciples of justice, peace, mercy, and hope. We offer our prayers for the sick, the oppressed, the youth, and those in most need of your mercy. Hear our humble petitions. Bless these religious articles that we may be fervent in prayer and charity. As we continue our journey as your pilgrim people here on earth, may we set our hearts on the road to heaven, our true home and reward, where you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And may Almighty and loving God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is offered. Let us walk in the peace of our Jesus Nazareno.
Thanks be to God.
Nuestro Padre Jesús Nazareno, sinasamba ka namin, pinipinto ka namin, aral mo ang aming buhay at kaligtasan. Nuestro Padre Jesús Nazareno, iligtas mo kami sa kasalanan. Ang krus mong kinamatayan ay sagisag ng aming kaligtasan. Nuestro Padre Jesús Nazareno, dinarangal ka na amin. Nuestro Padre Jesús Nazareno, dinulwalhati ka na amin. Nuestro Padre Jesús Nazareno, dinarangal ka na amin. Nuestro Padre Jesús Nazareno, dinulwalhati ka na amin.